For over 100 years, the cosmological story has been the story of the Big Bang, gravity, and relativity. But what if that story is wrong? And what if a new cosmological story and model is emerging? What then? How might a change in cosmology and the cosmological narrative impact today's society and contemporary culture? To explore these questions, we must first look at the concept of paradigm shift. Paradigm shift is one of these terms that we hear a lot of lately. But what exactly is a paradigm shift? Well, to begin, a paradigm is the dominant theory in any given discipline at any given time. And a paradigm shift happens when the dominant theory is replaced by another one. The term paradigm shift was coined by the physicist and philosopher of science Thomas Kuhn in his seminal work, The Structure of Scientific Revolutions. In his book, Kuhn challenged the common conception of science, which was that science was a steady progression of the accumulation of new ideas. In a series of reviews of past major scientific advances, such as those ushered in by Galileo, Newton, and Einstein, Kuhn was able to show that this viewpoint was wrong. For Kuhn, science advanced the most by occasional revolutionary explosions of new knowledge, each revolution triggered by introduction of new ways of thought that are so large and so different, they must be called new paradigms. In other words, a paradigm shift is scientific change that is forced to happen. For Kuhn, a paradigm shift happens over a process or a cycle, and it has very distinct stages. These stages are pre-science. This is a pre-stage where the field or discipline has no workable paradigm to successfully guide its work. Then we have normal science, the normal step, where the field has a scientifically based model of understanding that works. Then model drift. Here, the model of understanding begins to drift due to the accumulation of anomalies and phenomenon that the model simply cannot explain. After model drift, we enter model crisis. At this stage, the model drift becomes so excessive that the model is essentially broken. It can no longer serve as a reliable guide to problem solving, and any attempts to patch the model up and make it work fail. At this stage, the field is in anguish. After model crisis comes model revolution. This begins when serious candidates for a new model emerge. It's a revolution because the new model is so radically different from the old. Finally, we arrive at paradigm change. Here, a single new paradigm emerges and the field changes from the old to the new paradigm. When this step ends, the new paradigm becomes the new normal science and the Kuhn cycle is complete. Overall, the Kuhn cycle looks something like this: pre-science, normal science, crisis, revolution. New normal science, new crisis, new revolution. And it continues. Can you guess what stage we are currently in? Well, looking at the present discourse on cosmology and at scientists' own words, it is becoming apparent that we are in the midst of the Kuhn paradigm shift cycle and appear to presently be well within the model crisis stage. Today, the biggest topic in debate in cosmology definitely seems to be cosmology itself. Mainstream science magazines and non-science magazines are full of headlines suggesting that cosmology is in deep trouble. While scientists have been aware of a crisis in cosmology since at least the 1990s, in very recent years, that awareness has increased exponentially. As Eric Lerner has shown, in 1995, there was about one reference every year to the crisis. By the beginning of the 2000s, it went up to 5 references per year, and then 12 references by the middle of the 2000s. By the second part of the present decade, it was about 24 references per year. But then, in 2019, it shot up to 130 references per year. That is a drastic increase in just the last 2 years. This upward trend can be interpreted as a strong indication that we are at Kuhn's crisis stage. While scientists do not agree on the nature of the crisis, there is definitely a growing general awareness, both in cosmology and the mainstream media, that there is a crisis. I found that many mainstream articles and video deal with one or both of the following as it relates to cosmology and the Big Bang model. Anomaly, meaning something that deviates from what is standard, normal, or expected, and or contradiction, meaning new information, measurements, observations, and or findings that undermine, contradict, and or oppose the major principles, assumptions, and expectations of the Big Bang theory in some way. In Kuhn's paradigm shift model, when there are a little bit of anomalies and contradictions, then the dominant model or normal science can be said to be in a state of drift. When too many anomalies and contradictions accumulate, which the model cannot adequately explain or fix, then the model is in a state of crisis. The overabundance of mainstream material dealing with the ever-increasing anomalies and contradictions in contemporary cosmology, including from very well-known non-scientific sources like Forbes and Business Insider, suggests that we have definitely reached a crisis point. Drawing on Kuhn, this implies that the Big Bang model is broken and cannot be fixed. I will leave it to the natural and physical scientists to discuss and debate the nature of the cosmological crisis. But as a discourse analyst, I wish to make some observations about the articles and videos themselves. While many of the articles and video titles mention, quote, a crisis in Big Bang cosmology, their content and conclusions do not question or problematize the Big Bang as one might expect, though some do give lip service to the possible need for a new physics. When compared with the titles, the conclusions are disproportionate at best and apologist at worst, with a couple of sources even concluding that contradictions in the Big Bang model are strengths because they open the door for, quote, new and exciting areas of research within the Big Bang model. Talk about doubling down on a broken theory. Now, in critical discourse analysis, this can be identified as a problematic discursive strategy wherein the tone of the article's titles do not match the tone of the article's content and conclusion, thereby misleading the reader. This is a sneaky rhetorical device where the reader is led to assume one thing from the title, only to end up with an altogether different and even contradictory conclusion at the article's end. Rather than really address the crisis of Big Bang cosmology in a meaningful way, many of these sources downplay it or even double down on it, thereby shielding it. Some going as far as to characterize anomalies and contradictions that undermine the Big Bang model as strengths rather than flaws. Now, as a side note, even if editors are just using the phrase crisis in cosmology as clickbait with no intention of actually addressing it, the very fact that so many people, both within science and in the popular mainstream culture, want to know or read about a cosmological crisis can be interpreted as more proof that the Big Bang may be losing credibility. Another bizarre claim made by mainstream sources about cosmology is that the universe is far more strange or weird than we originally thought, and that this is why there are so many anomalies and contradictions that the Big Bang cannot address. This type of deflection is especially interesting because it blames the failures and inadequacies of standard cosmology on the cosmos rather than the model or theory. An internet search brings up numerous titles dealing with the quote-unquote strangeness or weirdness of the universe. Quote, the universe is stranger than we thought. Our solar system is even stranger than we thought. The universe turns out to be much bigger and weirder than anyone thought. Unexplained phenomena keep suggesting the universe isn't what we thought, etc., etc., etc. This rationalization, that the universe is stranger than we thought, is increasingly repeated in popular science magazines and websites. Repetition is another device that is used in dominant discourse and text, one that can create a false sense of authority and truthfulness, because when something is repeated often enough, it takes on an air of truth that can mislead readers into agreeing with false conclusions. The repetition of a false or speculative reality, in this case, that the universe just keeps getting weirder and weirder, prevents the reader from entertaining an alternative reality, such as the Big Bang is not adequately equipped to address the anomalies and contradictions of its field. The emphasis on weirdness ultimately negates the crisis in Big Bang cosmology and prevents deeper discussions of the implications of the crisis. It's interesting to point out that in the pre-Big Bang era of the Enlightenment, any claim that the universe was just too weird to understand would have been considered laughable. After all, the prime mover in the Age of Reason would never create a universe that was irrational. So why is it not only tolerated today, but exclaimed and celebrated? The universe's weirdness or nonconformity is accepted because of the attitudes that resulted from the cultural changes ushered in via the application of relativity to the non-sciences and broader culture in the first place. Because of these cultural changes and the acceptance and celebration of relativistic and paradoxical thinking, there appears to be an inability to consider weirdness and strangeness as critical warning signs of fundamental theoretical errors and problems. But under Kuhn's analysis, the acceptance and celebration of weirdness or paradoxical thinking are just further indications of a model in crisis. Within Kuhn's framework, doubling down on a broken model or blaming the model's inadequacies on the strange and wacky universe are all things that we could expect from a model that is dying. But no matter how they try to spin it, given everything we discussed, there is no denying that standard cosmology is a model in crisis.